In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your USB storage properly so that it will be detected by the USB Loader GX. Without further ado, let's get started. So if the USB Loader GX won't detect the external USB drive, then there might be something wrong with the setup. Some of you might see this problem. As soon as you click the USB Loader GX start button, you will see a black screen. And it redirects to the home screen. This problem doesn't mean that you have a faulty storage device, but most of the time you didn't set it up properly. So let's be a detective and find out the problem and solve it. The first thing is to make sure you plug the external drive to the USB port on the console's edge. If nothing happens, then go on to the next step. The next thing is to open your USB drive with the computer, then find out its file system. So select your drive, then right click, and choose properties. If your USB drive file system is not FAT32, then you have found one of the problems. So for example, my USB drive is NTFS. For best compatibility, we need to use a FAT32 formatted USB drive. And to do that, we need an app called GUI Format. So go to their website and download the app. Double click the app. Select your USB drive flatter, then press start. In some cases, you will need to close the file explorer to avoid an error. You can now close the app and recheck your USB drive file system. Now the drive is formatted as FAT32. Let's continue. When you have nothing on your USB drive, then you won't be able to load the USB Loader GX. If you have followed my previous guide about jailbreaking the Nintendo Wii, then you will have a folder called apps inside the copy to USB folder. Put the apps folder to your USB drive. But if you don't have that folder, then you can download the latest USB Loader GX from the link in the description. Open the downloaded archive with WinRAR or 7-zip, then extract the content to your USB drive. If you have done everything from the previous step but still your Wii doesn't detect your USB drive, then do this final step. Download MiniTool Partition Wizard 10 from the link in the description and install it. Then launch the app. Find your USB drive inside the MiniTool Partition Wizard. For my case, it is on drive G. Press the right mouse button, then choose Properties. Click the partition info. You might see that your drive partition type ID is hex B. For that case, we need to change that partition type ID to hex C. So again, press the right mouse button, then choose Change Partition Type ID. Select hex C FAT32 LBA from the drop-down menu, then press Yes. And then press the apply button. If you have tried everything, then it's time to run the USB Loader GX. There you go, you have successfully loaded the USB Loader GX. Please refer to my previous guide to install games. If you have an Xbox 360, you can use this guide too, especially the changing partition type ID step. So thanks for watching this video, and see you later.